When were you born? Sounds like a simple question. You just say a certain year, month, and day. But around the world, we reckon time differently. In Saudi Arabia, it's the 15th century. In Israel, it's the 58th. And we live in 24 different time zones. We all measure time relative to some starting point, a point we have chosen. But if we really want to know what time it is, we need to know when the cosmic clock started to tick. Did time begin when the universe began? Or did it start some other way? Once I was in a bike race. I wanted to impress some friends with my terrific speed. So I gave it everything I had. It was a close race. So close, I thought it was a tie. One kid said my opponent was quickest, but another said I was faster. So whose perception of time was correct? In a way, we were all right. Time is a measure of change. But how do we know things change? We rely on what our senses tell us. And primarily, we rely on what we can see. We rely on light. In the vacuum of space, light travels at a fixed speed of 186,000 miles per second. This is accepted as an absolute truth of the universe. And that, says cosmologist Jan 11, gives light a unique relationship to time.
It's actually completely remarkable. The speed of light is an absolute. It's never faster, it's never slower.
To understand the relativity of time, we really need to understand light. And once we start thinking about the nature of light, all of our familiar intuitions are turned on their heads.
If the speed of light is constant, then time and space must shift and distort depending on your particular point of view.
Einstein had this very profound insight when he started to think about something as simple as light. And he realized that if light was going to be the same for everybody in the universe, regardless of how fast they were moving or where they were in the universe, then space and time had to be different for different observers.
This means time is very personal. It depends on where you are and how fast you are moving. And the way you see your movement through time may not be the way others see your movement through time. Say, for instance, Jana has a doppelganger that rides the subways and taxis of New York. If Jana's doppelganger gets in a cab, and that cab travels at incredible speeds, time will flow differently for each woman.
If she flies past me in a taxi, it will appear to me that her time is running slower. From my doppelganger's point of view, the street with me on it, we're flying past her in the opposite direction. And as far as she's concerned, her time is normal. It's my time that's running slow.
To understand why this happens, imagine Jana turns on a double-sided laser whose pulsing beams bounce off the sidewalk below her and the balcony above her head. The pulses form a light clock. Each bounce of the laser beam is one tick. Jana sees the light go straight up and down, but her cab-riding double sees something quite different.
From the perspective of the cab, the light appears to take a long diagonal. And so it seems as though my clock is taking too long to tick. So it seems like my time is running slow.
If Jana's doppelganger turns on the laser in the taxi, she will see the beam hitting the ceiling and floor right above and below her. But the Jana on the street sees the beam move diagonally. Because the beam has longer to travel, its tick looks slower.
from my perspective on the street, if I'm looking into the taxi, I see their light take a long diagonal, and so I think it's taking their clock too long to tick. From my perspective, their clocks are running slow.
The effect increases the faster you go. If the cab approaches the speed of light, the speed limit of the universe, time outside the cab appears to stand still.
If that taxi was to fly by at the speed of light, it would look like my clock was never going to tick, like my time had stood still, like time was frozen.
So which observer is correct? The Janna who's standing still, or the Janna in motion?
My doppelganger and I just fundamentally disagree on the passage of time. And it's true, we're both right. Time is relative.
Relativity means that there can be no single universal time. However, there was one moment when all perspectives on time must have been the same. A moment when everything existed in one single place. The Big Bang.
One of the hardest things to grasp about the idea of the Big Bang and the creation of the universe is the idea that time itself may have begun in that big event. That space was created in the Big Bang and time began to tick. Before our Big Bang, there might not have been space or time.
Janna believes the Big Bang was probably when all the various time streams in the universe began. That since then, time has passed differently in different places, depending on how those places have moved. But could we create places in our universe where time can appear to stop and then begin again? If we could hide an event from light, could we also hide it from time? These are questions Professor Alex Gaeta asked himself. A former competition tennis player, Alex is a physicist at Cornell University specializing in ultra-fast optics. This technology is usually used for high-speed data transmission. But after reading a paper written by theorists at Imperial College, he realized it could also create a gap in time.
You know, light is an electromagnetic disturbance. The minute things start changing, that's an indication that time is passing. So all these changes that are occurring are creating all these electromagnetic disturbances that we can detect and measure as passage of time. What we've figured out is a way of essentially turning off the lights, turning them back on without, you know, you sensing that they've ever actually been turned off.
What would happen if you turned off the light shining on time long enough to hide an event? Say, for instance, Alex is in a close game with his son, Max. He's coming up to match point and he wants to win. If Alex could create a hole in time, no one could see him do this. To observers, including his son, Alex wins the set without pause. Right now, this is impossible. But all great things start small.